Thank you, Jesus. Looking back in my life, I see many things you have done for me. Therefore, I say thank you, Jesus. My name is Lawrence Oji, popularly known as Pastor Solution. I worship at New Covenant Church Edmonton. I'm the church evangelist. I'm also the coordinator of STEDI, Solution to Alcohol and Drug Addiction Initiative, which badge I've been wearing for several years, just to encourage people who are still in the bondage of drug addiction that there is a way out. I used to be a drug addict, a chronic drug addict for several years. I was hopeless, but it was so bad that my own mother, who loved me so much, even prayed to God that I should die so that she could weep once and stop weeping. I know that there are some parents who are still going through such pain. I put my parents through pain so much, my mother in particular. When a woman could not recognize the child she gave birth to, my life was inside prison, out. I used to leave prison and the prison warders would ask me, Solution, till when? Because they knew I would come back. Prison became my main home and I used to visit outside. And this lasted for over 20-something long years. They have any future? They have any plans? No wonder at my age, well over 60, my first child is 8 years old. I thank God for His mercy. I know some people have found themselves in that situation. Recently, I ministered to someone who has been in drug for 35 years. Today, he's an evangelist. He's working for the Lord. He goes to drug joints. Why am I saying all this? I want to encourage someone out there, a relative of a drug addict, or a drug addict himself who may be listening, who may be watching. There is hope in Christ. The Bible tells us there is hope for a tree, even if it's cut down. It will sprout again and bud, so long it receives the scent of water. Brethren, the scent of water the Bible is talking about is the Word of God. So as I speak to you, I was a chronic addict and jailbird for several years, tried a lot of things, went to different hospitals, tried to get clean, but every effort to get clean immersed me deeper in the abyss of drug addiction until I met Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. The only one who has the power to deliver anybody from no matter what the devil has thrown at them. Instead, our motto is, there's no life broken, shattered, battered that cannot be gathered. So there is hope for you. There is hope for that child. Don't give up on anybody. My case was so bad that I did everything I could to kill myself. Everything I could do to kill myself, I tried it. I stabbed myself with a kitchen knife and my intestines came out with a kitchen knife. But God didn't just let me go. I'll be driving a car and I hear a voice that says, do it now. I'll just let the car tumble on the way. When I met late Dr. David Wilkerson, he came to Italy to launch his book, Suicide. He told me exactly that what I was going through, I was the devil. I said, I knew. God wants me to live. God wants you to live. But the devil has held you down with the spirit of drug addiction or any form of addiction. But that same God who delivered me is still doing the same work. All he says is, come to me. I'm inviting you. It does not matter how long you have been on drugs. It does not matter how long you've been a write-off. If only you will answer that call today, He will clean you. He will get you cleaned up with His blood. He's so faithful, He's so loving. God is faithful. I did a lot of things to destroy myself, but today, to His glory, I remember I'll be driving along when I hear a voice These are some of the accidents I caused by myself when I had that voice to commit suicide. So you may be in that same situation. These accidents, the many more, but today to his glory, here I am with Sherry Booth, wife of Tony Blair, the former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Here I am with David Cameron, who just passed Prime Minister of the United States. So what am I saying? Jesus has the power to bring you from no matter what death you have fallen and bring you to sit with princes and kings. The only thing you need to do is just answer the call. There is no way the devil has dealt with you that Christ Jesus cannot repair you and rebuild you. He will heal and build you up. So all I'm saying, come and receive Christ. Wherever you are right now, no, it doesn't matter. If you have the privilege of listening to me, or if even watching, or your loved one is watching on your behalf, I just want you to open your heart as I pray for you. I say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I don't know who the devil thinks he has destroyed. The way he thought he destroyed me for years, until your grace found me. Lord, as I speak, let your grace and your mercy locate such a person. Let there be testimonies that there will be joy in heaven. Lord, I know that distance is not a barrier for you in any way. That guy who is held in the spirit of addiction, that lady, that girl, that child, that marriage that is on the brink of breaking down because one partner is on drugs or both, Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus, let that same grace that found me locate them now. Let them begin to answer this call, Father. Destroy the stony heart and turn it to a heart of flesh. As I send forth this word, Lord, it is written, you sent your word and you healed them and delivered them out of all their destruction. May the word you have put in my mouth, Father, begin to locate them. Such people, Lord, let them be located. Bring them out of the pit of drug addiction, out of the pit of frustration, out of the pit of suicide. For the Bible tells us that you are not pleased with the death of the sinner. Bring them out, Lord. And I pray, Lord, that you will bring them into your vineyard. The Bible says that the harvest is plenty, but the laborers are few. That I should pray to you, the Lord of the harvest, to send in more laborers. Lord, I pray among those prostitutes, among those drug addicts, among those junkies, among those hopeless people, Lord, who have been written off. Jesus, you died for them. Begin to draw them to yourself, Lord. Let them be enlisted in your army today, in your kingdom, Father, so that they'll be joy in heaven, all to your glory. What you have done in my life, Papa, do twice as much in the life of somebody today. It does not matter what level the devil has dealt with them. You are more than able. Just a touch from you, Lord. One touch from you will settle the matter. And I ask that you do it today because I ask in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, I who used to go to prisons and the prison warders will ask me, till when? Till when? I will spend 2 years in prison, spend 6 months out. 1 year in prison, 3 months out. There was a day I left prison. The same day I was taken back to prison. But today, I go to prisons to minister to prisoners. God can do the same thing for anybody. He's no respecter of person. All you need to do, he said, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. He said, come to me, no matter how your sins may be, no matter how your iniquities may be. He said, I will make them to become as white as snow, and they'll become as wool. All you need is just to come. Jesus is here to deliver you. He is here to set you free. Jesus wants you to enjoy life and enjoy it in abundance. You don't need to take your life. You didn't give life to yourself. I tried all those things, but I thank God that he spared my life. And if you are still alive and you are listening to me, it is your day, it's your opportunity. Don't miss this opportunity. And as you do, God will show up for you. You will share your own testimony. And as I wrote my own testimony from prison to pulpit, you will write your own. But finally, before I go, I want to tell you about my third book. It is titled Not Without a Scar. So as you've listened to me now, whatsoever choice you make leaves a scar. The scar it will leave is a mark. It's either the choice you make is embrace Christ today, and he will take you from that pit onto your pulpit, or you choose to ignore it, you will remain with the devil, and of course, you have only yourself to blame. There's no choice that doesn't leave a scar. I made a choice to be on drugs for several years, to be a jailbird, to attempt suicide, and even though I don't feel any pain here, I still have this scar to remind me. Please, today, the Bible tells us, today is the day of salvation. If you hear his voice, do not harden your heart. I'm sure that God wants to do something great in your life. That is why you've got the opportunity to. So you mother, father, uncle, brother, sister, don't give up on that addict. There is hope for them. Just introduce them. Invite them to New Covenant Church Edmonton, where I worship, or introduce them to Stay There, Solution to Alcohol and Drug Addiction Initiative. We have our offices at Chestnut Community Center, 280 St. Anne's Road, London, N15, 5BN, or introduce them to our second one, The Dining Place, the 7 The Concourse, London, NW9 5XB. Our telephone numbers are +44 if you are calling from outside the United Kingdom, 788-908-0268. 788-908-0268. The second one is +44744-859-5107. The email address is solutionministries2001@yahoo.com. 2001 because I was delivered in the year 2001. So my email address is solutionministries2001@yahoo.com. Call us at any time, send email. God will deliver you. What he did for me, he will do twice, even for you. God bless you as you've listened, and may you share your own testimony quick. Where you're going is not the way. So I said, drug is not the way. Christ is the way. He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. He said, I'm the light of the world. Whosoever follows me shall not fall in darkness. He said, I'm the bread of life. If you're hungry, come to me. I'm the living water. I'm the great healer. He has shown all this unto me. And you know what? He said, I'm the restorer. He will restore you. I don't care what you've lost. He said in his word, the thief comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy, but I've come that they may have life and have it more abundantly. Jesus does not only want to give you life, he wants to give you life in abundance. Today is your day. As you receive him, God will bless you indeed.